It's Monday, December 7th, 2020. And yeah, we still have to wear these. But I don't have to wear one inside. Today I got some news for you. NativeScript has been accepted into OpenJS. Yes, that's right. All right, so I saw this tweet today. We are honored to be incubating alongside a family of inspiring JS projects and look forward to continually strengthening JavaScript as a fun and natural choice for global development communities, no matter the target, runtime, or platform. Very nice little message on Twitter. And this is in response to OpenJS Foundation. So what is OpenJS Foundation? Well, if we take a look at Wikipedia, OpenJS Foundation is an organization that was founded in 2019. It was a result of the JavaScript Foundation merging with Node.js Foundation, two nonprofits that help the JavaScript community out. And according to Wikipedia, the mission is to foster healthy growth of the JavaScript and web ecosystem by providing a neutral organization to host projects and collaboratively fund activities that benefit the ecosystem as a whole. So this means that potentially there is some funding that's going to happen here to help develop all these frameworks that are under OpenJS, including NativeScript. OpenJS is made up of 29 open source JavaScript projects. Maybe I should go and update Wikipedia because now I believe it's 35. Anybody want to do that? We'll check the OpenJS Foundation website in a second. So they include things like Appium, Dojo, jQuery, Node.js, and Webpack. And founding members include Google, Microsoft, IBM, PayPal, GoDaddy, and Joyent. Ooh, Joyent. All right, so let's check their site, their official OpenJS Foundation website. You can go there and check it out. You can take a look at the projects that are listed there. And this news is so new that NativeScript is not listed on this page yet, but it will be soon. If you take a look at the homepage though, you'll scroll down a little bit and you'll see the latest news. It says NativeScript joins OpenJS Foundation as an incubating project right there. It's a pretty big honor to be among the list of such greats as jQuery, jQuery UI, jQuery Mobile, Node.js, Moment, Webpack, all these amazing libraries and JavaScript open source projects that you know and love. And JerryScript, JerryScript? Okay, I gotta click on JerryScript. What is JerryScript? It's a lightweight JavaScript engine intended to run on a very constrained devices such as microcontrollers. Wow, that is tiny, less than 64 kilobytes. All right, I don't know much about JerryScript, but it seems pretty interesting. Check it out. I wonder if it was created by somebody named Jerry. Maybe. All right, so we got a December 7th blog post right there that talks about NativeScript and joining OpenJS Foundation. It says NativeScript empowers access to native platform APIs from JavaScript directly. The result is a streamlined and delightful development experience, minimizing language switching and IDE jumping. There's an ever-growing number of use cases, including full spectrum of iOS and Android platform API development with desktop runtime possibilities, leveraging common web development skills, CSS, JavaScript language itself. Developers can unlock the full experience and performance from a rich API offering of iOS and Android platforms. I mean, you watch this channel, you know that that's what NativeScript does, but it's pretty cool to see that here. NativeScript is particularly well suited to provide opportunities in significant code reuse between web and mobile development. Sharing of code between web and mobile, I talk a lot about this on this channel as well. NativeScript can be integrated with other native platform APIs to continually enrich and expand JavaScript's capabilities. That's a pretty interesting statement right there. Probably more to hear about this in the coming months ahead. I know of at least one project that this is being worked on that's pretty interesting that I can't wait to share, but I can't right now. So, the framework not only allows usage of plain JavaScript TypeScript to create applications, but also allows integration with Angular, Vue.js, React, Svelte, and any JavaScript-driven front-end framework to allow developers to reuse their web knowledge and so on. So I've talked about Svelte before here on this channel. You saw a video from me, was it 2 weeks ago, where I tried out Svelte Native. If you missed that video, I'll post a link to it. It's gonna be somewhere here or down below. We also checked out React NativeScript earlier in the year, 2020. I even have an interview with the creator of that, Jamie Birch. Check that out here as well. I cover lots of content on Vue and Angular flavors as well on this channel. So if you do want to learn more about NativeScript, do subscribe to the channel if you're not already, and check out the links below for courses that I have as well. So why is NativeScript joining OpenJS? Well, let's take a look at this. NativeScript was created in 2014 and quickly gained popularity. The software consulting company and strong NativeScript community member NStudio assumed responsibility for the open source project in June 2020. They did this to support increased community interest and improved engagement with the core framework. Then the project shifted to an open governance model in June of 2020, and inspired by Node.js and JS Foundation and by other standards bodies. Joining OpenJS Foundation will allow the project to strengthen the focus on transparency and openness as a basis for growing the community around the world. So, this is good for everybody. Nathan Walker, senior partner at NStudio, says, "We're excited to be joining the OpenJS Foundation. We believe this will directly benefit both a wonderful community of developers and end users, businesses that rely on NativeScript worldwide. We've been involved in NativeScript for the past 6 years, and we see joining OpenJS as a natural step in its evolution. NativeScript is a uniquely delightful tool for empowering JavaScript developers with access to native platform APIs, and we are constantly inspired by the thoughtful and passionate community to improve the technology." And I know this firsthand. The community behind NativeScript is super passionate. It's not as big as React Native, or doesn't have the huge growth that Flutter has right now, but it does have a very stable and passionate community that has some growth as well. OpenJS is thrilled to welcome NativeScript. The foundation exists to house a diverse set of open source projects that contribute to the JavaScript ecosystem on a global scale, said Robin Jin, OpenJS Foundation Executive Director. And then there's a couple of comments from folks that use NativeScript that have apps published in the app stores that are successful apps. One of them is Tom Mazzone here, the CEO of Suite. And if you haven't checked out Suite, which is an app available in the Apple Store and the Play Store, check that app out because it's one of the best looking NativeScript apps that I've ever seen. Tom says, "I demand a lot from our development team in order to deliver the best user experience within the Suite app, and NativeScript has been able to deliver." And then Mike Karzima from iMedia Inc. says, "Working with NativeScript has been the most fun I've had developing in years." And I can attest to that as well. It is a lot of fun, not always easy, but mobile development is often very difficult. But it is fun, and a lot of people love it, and that's why they stick with NativeScript, because of all the power and capabilities that this framework provides. So I want to congratulate the NativeScript team, NStudio, and all those folks that work on NativeScript day to day. Thank you very much for doing what you're doing, and congratulations. So, December 7th, a little news update for y'all. If you're not subscribed yet, click on that subscribe button. And thanks for watching this video. I'll see you next time.